The King Cobra John Kreese has always been a polarizing character, whether it's the original trilogy of The Karate Kid or in Cobra Kai. And while the series has done a great job of diving into his character, nothing can top his arc in the second half of Season 4. Was John Kreese always the villain, or was he misunderstood? Perhaps the parallel to Mr. Miyagi if he was on a darker path. This is why Kreese was misguided. Let's talk about how he coped with his trauma, why he does have a soft side, what his future holds, and more. It goes without saying that there are spoilers in this video, and if you haven't seen Season 4 yet, don't watch this video. And before we get started, I wanted to give a shout out to Pascal Aka for allowing me to use his music in this video. You guys may know Pascal already from my previous videos for his wonderful interpretations of the Cobra Kai themes and motifs. He's awesome, so do me a favor and please subscribe to his channel. Let's recap on what we know about Kreese so far. I'm going to try to summarize as much as I can since we have to cover his time in both the trilogy and Cobra Kai. Feel free to skip to the next chapter if you want to avoid the recap, but be warned, you may miss important details here that we'll talk about later on in the analysis. After his mother passes away and with no father figure, John Kreese is left to fend for himself and works at a local diner in 1965. Getting the idea to enlist in the army from a poster crumpled up and thrown on the ground by his bully David, Kreese later witnesses him abusing his girlfriend Betsy. Kreese fights both David and James, and although losing the fight at first, manages to overpower the two. As he leaves for basic training, Betsy sees him off and he promises to come back to her. During his time in Vietnam in 1968, he is sought out by Captain Turner to be part of a special forces team, learning Tong Sudo alongside his friends Ponytail and Terry Twig Silver. During a mission, Kreese was ordered by Turner to blow the charges planted by Ponytail, but refused in order to save Ponytail's life. Because of Twig's radio going off, the enemy is alerted to their location. Ponytail is executed and the remaining soldiers are held prisoner. In 1969, the captured soldiers are picked to fight against each other to the death over a snake pit. When Twig is picked as Turner's opponent, Kreese takes his place instead to save his friend's life. Turner tries to get into John's head as he tells him Betsy is dead, which he knew after training Kreese a year earlier, giving him an advantage in the fight. However, Kreese manages to overpower Turner and as reinforcements arrive, takes Turner's lessons to heart and shows him no mercy. Upon letting everyone out of the cage, Terry hugs him and promises him that he will be there for him for his entire life in case he ever needs anything. In 1975, after getting matching tattoos, Kreese expresses interest in entering Cobra Kai into the 7th All Valley, but Terry states that if he doesn't take over his father's company, he will be cut out of the inheritance. Promising to pay his half of the rent and also to help continue Cobra Kai in the future, they both make their pact and Kreese goes on to run Cobra Kai by himself. By the time 1984 rolls around, Kreese's Cobra Kai dojo has a 2-time All Valley champion in Johnny Lawrence, his top pupil. Johnny claims that Mr. Miyagi, the soon-to-be sensei of his rival Daniel LaRusso, jumped him and his friends on Halloween. Believing him to be the aggressor, Kreese initiates a challenge to settle the feud between the two boys, with Miyagi responding that they will do so only at the tournament. As Daniel makes it to the semifinals, Kreese orders Bobby Brown to injure Daniel's leg. However, Daniel manages to recover and fights Johnny in the finals. Kreese orders Johnny to attack his injured leg, but Daniel manages to persevere and defeat Johnny, uncrowning Cobra Kai as champion. Angry at Johnny's loss, Kreese intimidates Miyagi and Daniel and starts to choke out Johnny after a heated argument. Miyagi intervenes and manages to defeat Kreese without throwing a punch, not only embarrassing him but further adding to his already damaged reputation due to his behavior at the tournament. The following summer, after having all students leave the dojo, Kreese visits Silver to turn in the dojo keys. Silver refuses and promises to get revenge, having remembered his promise from Vietnam. During his trip in Tahiti, Kreese makes a request to make Daniel's knuckles bleed in retaliation for what Miyagi did to him. He also comes back from the dead to scare Daniel, but is soon confronted by Miyagi. Wanting a rematch, Kreese is easily taken care of while Miyagi also goes on to defeat Silver. Despite Silver's heavy mind games and Mike Barnes' intimidation, Daniel wins his second championship, leading Cobra Kai to be banned for the next 30 plus years. Outside of trying to re-enlist and taking various odd jobs, including presumably a handout from Terry Silver, it's unknown of what Kreese was up to during this time. After Johnny Lawrence successfully appeals the ban of Cobra Kai from the All Valley and leads the dojo to victory, Kreese attempts to reconcile twice with Johnny but fails in doing so. On the third attempt, Kreese apologizes for his actions in the past and brings a repaired second place trophy, causing Johnny to have a change of heart. Kreese observes the new Cobra class and is also present during the unorthodox cement truck training, revealing himself as Johnny Sensei to the class and giving them a kick in the pants to help with the lesson. On his way to tell Johnny about Robbie, Daniel realizes Kreese has returned from the dead a second time and swears to take on Cobra Kai head on. When Daniel puts out commercials for Miyagi-Do Karate, Kreese wishes Johnny to respond to the commercial, being present when Cobra Kai interrupts Miyagi-Do's demonstration at Valley Fest. Miguel is worried about Kreese telling false stories to the students and confides in this to Johnny, who follows Kreese after class to see him staying at a homeless shelter. Johnny offers to give him a second chance in exchange for following his lead on instruction. Kreese agrees and becomes a co-sensei to Cobra Kai. After teaching another day of class together, Kreese advises Johnny to take his own lessons to heart and to go all in, prompting him to look for Robbie. After Hawk and Cobra Kai lose to Miyagi-Do, which was a result of Dimitri writing a bad review about Kreese, Kreese advises him to finish the fight and to trash Miyagi-Do. While Johnny goes off to visit his dying friend Tommy, Kreese begins to train Cobra Kai in the same level of ruthlessness he taught in the 80s. He also visits Daniel and tells them to prepare his students for the war. When Johnny returns, Kreese advises Johnny to take them to Coyote Creek for training and soon sees the influence Kreese has on his students. Due to differing philosophies, Johnny bans Kreese from the dojo. However, because of his dealings with Armand, the landlord who doesn't like Johnny, Kreese swoops in and steals the dojo from him after the school fight. 2 weeks later, Kreese is visited by Daniel who is looking for Johnny. Although Daniel says he won't fight him, Kreese responds that it's inevitable and Cobra Kai will finish it. The dojo also goes through some changes with addition by subtraction and begins to look for a new champion. Deducing that Tori needs help with her bills and her landlord is giving her a hard time, Kreese confronts the landlord and gets her rent taken care of, resulting in Tori being able to rejoin Cobra Kai. He also tries to persuade Johnny once again into joining Cobra Kai, but when he brings up "our boy will come home," Johnny tells him to stay away from Miguel and his family or he will be killed. However, Kreese was talking about Robbie and visits him in juvie to recruit him to joining Cobra Kai. Although Robbie refuses at first, he takes his advice to heart about striking first and is able to hold his own against Sean. After the fight at the laser tag arena, Amanda goes to confront Kreese and slaps him, resulting in a restraining order being put against her. Kreese also manages to recruit some new students, including Kyler, and kicks Mitch out of the dojo. Although Armand attempts to force Kreese out, he retaliates by beating him up and his nephews, promising open season on Miyagi-Do. Kreese once again gives another final chance to Johnny by showing up to his dojo, but Johnny once again refuses. At the city council meeting, things get heated when the three senseis attempt to appeal the decision to ban the All Valley, but thanks to Miguel and Sam's intervention, the tournament is saved. Robbie seeks out Kreese, who allows him to stay the night and begins to learn a few moves. After Robbie and the gang bring the snake to Kreese, he tells them that Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang are working together, and off-screen orders them to invade the LaRusso household. Because of this, Johnny confronts Kreese and fights him. While he is distracted by Robbie, Kreese grabs the upper hand and chokes out Johnny, but Daniel intervenes and prepares to kill Kreese until Miguel and Sam arrive. They agree to settle things at the tournament where the loser leaves town. Kreese calls Silver for help once again, but is at first rejected. He also attempts to sway Robbie to join once again, who refuses at first but later comes around. Tracking down where Terry is, they have a conversation about how things have changed and Terry refuses to help at first, but slowly lets out who he once was. During a class where Robbie is teaching Cobra Kai Miyagi-Do, Kreese sees Tori's upset and finds out that Amanda inadvertently caused her to get fired. He confronts her in a grocery store and warns her to back off. When Kenny tries out for the dojo, Kreese dismisses him and says he doesn't have time to train cowards. After class that day, Silver visits him and shows that he still has fight in him, and Kreese can tell that he misses it. Sensing that Robbie has found Cobra Kai material, Kreese agrees to let Kenny on the team after he learns to strike first. Silver officially joins as a co-sensei, and after the scuffle at the drive-in, Kreese wants to retaliate, but Silver convinces him that they should be smarter about this and use their wisdom. Both Cobra Kai senseis confront Johnny and Daniel, with Kreese trying to get into Johnny's head. Realizing he has a problem with Silver's teachings, the two go to dinner that night to discuss. Kreese protests that he has everything under control, but Silver responds that they should focus on the students and forget about the past. Kreese agrees and sees Silver's point of view as they move forward. The next time we see them teach class together, they teach about weakness and make a bet on who has the better fighters. Silver ends up winning and Kreese brings the beers later that night. However, he goes on to tell Silver to not to step out of line and watch out for landmines and to avoid undermining him. When Stingray attempts to rejoin, Kreese dismisses him and bans him from the dojo. Later that night, Silver shows Kreese that he rebought the old location of the Cobra Kai dojo and fights Johnny Lawrence in front of him. Besting Johnny and attempting to finish him, Kreese demands Silver to back off, causing confusion. At the tournament, Kreese and Silver coach Cobra Kai, with Kreese notably telling Robbie that he's fighting his opponent and not his friend. Before Robbie and Eli fight, Kreese tells Johnny that it wasn't his plan for Terry to call him to the old dojo. Despite everything that happened, Kreese tells Johnny that he cares about both him and Robbie, and that Robbie could lead Cobra Kai in the future. During Tori's match with Sam, Kreese has a change of heart and decides to change the course of history by going against Silver's advice. He tells her that whatever she does in her fight, it's up to her. Later that night after Cobra Kai wins, Terry and John share a drink to celebrate. Silver reveals that he knows Kreese's weakness is Johnny Lawrence, and that he is Silver's weakness. He states that it was never about the original goal, and has Kreese arrested to take the fall for beating up Stingray, effectively usurping the dojo from Kreese. First, let's talk about how trauma affected Kreese's life. One could say that Kreese is the parallel to Mr. Miyagi in a lot of ways, the anti-Miyagi so to speak. Narioshi was plagued by the loss of his family for years and resorted to alcohol to cope with it at times, as we saw in The Karate Kid. One of the first factors that we have to look at is the death of John Kreese's mother. As he mentions to Tori later on, it was a sickness that he didn't understand nor knew how to help with. It's tragic when you think about it due to the fact that mental health care resources were nowhere near abundant as they are now and the stigma towards mental health at that time. In fact, it was around that time that Kreese was working in the diner during the mid-1960s that asylums were closed, which allowed people to return home and receive care in their communities. The downside to that, those who didn't have those resources and support mechanisms became homeless. Unless the writers dive deeper into Kreese's story later on, we can assume he had no father figure to guide him either, leaving him on his own after his mother takes her life. As we saw in Season 3 during the flashbacks, it's also easy to see that the result of his mother's death also made him a target for bullying, notably by both David and James. When Kreese meets and ends up dating Betsy, this is one of the only positive things in his life. More on this later. His time with Captain Turner also went on to affect him to his core, and even prior to going on one of the missions. When Kreese got the best of Captain Turner during the spar, it was clear that he fought with both honor and mercy, expressing concern that he injured his instructor. Even when asking to go easy on his enemy should they surrender, Turner reinforced that they should never trust their enemy and to not hesitate. On their special mission, this is exactly what happened. Because Kreese hesitated when Silver's radio went off and Ponytail was still setting the charges, he waited too long and his unit got captured by the enemy, resulting in his friend's death. And while I can't say if he made the right choice or not, we can certainly sympathize being put into a situation like that because he still showed concern for his friend. The fact that he also had to see the execution so close to where he was is something that goes to affect him to this very day, especially in Season 3 when Armand walks in to evict him. This would clearly point towards Kreese suffering from PTSD, which we will also touch on in a little bit. Although we know they were captured for more than likely nearly a year, or at least months at a time, it's unknown what kind of torture that Kreese, Silver, and Turner endured while being locked in that cage. It seems to have also affected Silver to some degree, as he was scared to death to fight his own captain. Kreese also shows some form of fear and shock when watching the soldiers being forced to fight to the death, as we can see in some of these shots. When Kreese goes to take Silver's place, Turner lays out a bombshell of what happened to Betsy, purposely trying to get into his head before they fight so Kreese would be at a disadvantage. This also works as it deeply affects him and also is what happened to Mr. Miyagi in World War II. While he was deployed, he found out that complications at birth killed both his wife and his son. In a rare moment of vulnerability that we see from Kreese throughout the series, he drops to a knee to process what he just heard and presumably to prepare to grieve over his love. It's clear that Kreese still shows what Turner deems his humanity or rationale during this fight. Having to fight for his life over a snake pit against his former captain and this same trait that led him to not only be captured but for his friend to die. This taunt is what pushes Kreese over the edge when he starts truly embracing his beliefs of no mercy, killing his captain and going down this path to change him forever. This specific moment in his life also goes on to affect during his fight with Johnny, further reminding him of what happened. Everything that happened in Vietnam is not only what changed Kreese, but caused him to morph into that of his former teacher, Captain Turner. Much like how Daniel is a byproduct of Miyagi and Johnny is a byproduct of Kreese, Kreese is not only a byproduct of Turner, but a near emulation of him, down to smoking cigars like he did. This specific incident of his trauma is what affects him to this very day, but we have to first look at the time he was Johnny's sensei. When we see Johnny first enrolled into the dojo in a flashback in Season 2, Kreese doesn't accept any form of weakness whether it be crying or cowering when spoken to. In 1984, it's clear that he runs a tight ship with the students, using the same lessons he learned from his captain to not show any mercy or lose concentration. This hardcore discipline would also result in punishment of having the students do push-ups on their knuckles. Pain, fear, and defeat do not exist in this dojo. You don't wait for the enemy to attack, you strike first and hard, and you show them no mercy. Even if the enemy is already down, or even if it means an illegal attack, you finish them off. You also attack their weakness, despite how questionable it might be. With Johnny losing the finals match, Kreese overreacts to the loss of not accepting defeat and begins to attack his own students. This is also what ultimately leads Kreese to losing all of his students, and also going in to turn the keys to Terry Silver. As I mentioned in my prior video about Terry Silver, it's also clear that he has his own trauma and affects his way of thinking and personality. We see the two making racist comments and remarks on different occasions towards Mr. Miyagi, more than likely due to their time in Vietnam. Because of what happened with his mother, it's more than likely Kreese refused the help and resources available because of remembering the lack of resources available to his mother and his assumption of them not understanding what happened to him. His untreated trauma would explain why Kreese has flashbacks when present-day situations remind him of what happened. There's also certain times and scenes where he has this look on his face as he's reliving it, or says something along the lines of, "If you saw what I saw, well, be glad you didn't." The concept of war is still in his head as he still holds a grudge towards Daniel, especially when Daniel makes a commercial subtly talking about Cobra Kai. He also advises Hawk to retaliate and finish the fight, ordering him and others to trash the dojo to send a message. When confronting Daniel at the dojo, this is proven further when he says, "War doesn't end. Peace is just the lull between battles." Because of the way he is, and although he agreed to do things the way Johnny did, he's too set in his ways and uses his experience as a guideline for his dojo. This mindset causes him to go back on his word with Johnny and causes him to be excommunicated from the dojo. However, it's this same mindset that he uses to take back Cobra Kai from under Johnny's nose. Because Johnny is still trying to ground himself as a sensei, Kreese sees this as weakness for showing mercy, resulting in Miguel being paralyzed. Therefore, he takes the dojo back by force because Johnny's way didn't work, and he believes only the way of the fist will. This also means still being focused on the fight at hand with the rival dojo of Miyagi-Do, finishing the fight once and for all in the war for the valley. Even in 2018, weakness will not exist in his dojo, purging all of those who care or have love for something because in his eyes that makes them weak, especially when he was once like that. Kreese is also not above doing what he has to do to win, even if it's recruiting the enemy of his enemy. This mentality, and all of what makes him into who he is what Terry Silver calls out when he wants to strike back for revenge. Terry explaining that there is a time and place to strike is what starts to open Kreese's eyes in some extent to the differing philosophies and what he has been doing all this time, stuck in a mindset of war and not using his wisdom to be better. Terry even explains what leads to his downfall. You've got the kids wrapped up in your old drama, and if you're not careful, it's going to take down Cobra Kai all over again. And although they are out of the military, Kreese asserts his dominance by reminding Silver he was the one who saved him and is the commanding officer. Let's talk about why Kreese does have a soft side and the good qualities he does possess. Even though he claimed later on in his life that there was no good or bad, he did what he thought was right at times. While it was none of his business and perhaps it reminded him of how his mother was possibly treated, he intervened when Betsy was being abused by her then boyfriend David. John joined the military to defend the honor of his country and to be a hero, even when being dismissed by Captain Turner for explaining his reasons for doing so. Although his superior called this his weakness, Kreese's loyalty to his friends is why he didn't detonate the charges and is also the same reason why he wasn't afraid to fight his own captain to save Terry Silver. As we see in 1975, Kreese understands what Silver is struggling with when he claims he worries about returning to a normal life. He reassures his friend that fear doesn't exist and that he didn't leave him behind. It's clear that this friendship goes beyond John saving Terry in one of my favorite moments of season 4. John is loyal to Terry just as Terry is loyal to him, which is what we saw from one side in Terry in Karate Kid Part 3, but now we get a closer look at that from John's point of view. Kreese is also excited about showing the students that Cobra Kai is the right way, possibly implying he has a passion for teaching. And although, as we discussed before, that he emulated Turner's teachings to the core, perhaps there was a part of him that wanted to teach students to avoid the path he went down by embracing those principles. After all, you can have good intentions and bad executions. We can see this occur in 1984. Although Johnny had lied about initially what happened at Halloween, Kreese took Johnny's side because it was to defend the honor of his student and to reignite Johnny's confidence, which Kreese explains from his point of view in the episode Bicephaly. While Johnny never directly heard Kreese say it or felt that Kreese cared about him, it's clear that Kreese was Johnny's Miyagi but was way stricter in how he dealt with Johnny. This is why Kreese told him to sweep the leg. He knew if his top student lost, it would haunt him for years. And he was right, that's how we got here in the first place. Upon initially viewing Kreese's arc in season 2, it's hard to determine if all of his actions were that to a similar ploy played by Terry Silver. However, from what we know now with season 4, I think there were some good intentions and genuine actions that occurred in season 2. The fight between Kreese and Johnny, for example, only occurred when Johnny struck first. I don't necessarily blame Johnny though, given from what he knew Kreese was like in the last interaction he ever had with him. Despite this fight, Kreese apologized for what he did and owned up to his actions. He even suddenly hints at his fight with Captain Turner and how it changed him forever as he looks away for a brief second. While it's unclear that this is the same trophy he broke, he did bring a second place trophy as a peace offering for the one he broke in 1984. While respecting the boundary of Johnny being the lead sensei, it is a speech that he gives to Johnny's students that not only back up Lawrence's lesson, but also directly support Johnny himself. This is also evidenced when he fist bumps Johnny and admires him for a job well done. Kreese also tells him to never say never, as since he brought Cobra Kai from the dead, there could be a chance that he trained Robbie someday, which we may see happen in season 5. When Johnny throws him to the homeless shelter, Kreese begins to explain more about his past and what happened after 1984. We can see that his past still haunts him, and it's been a while that he's talked about it, as again his face tells it all. This is one of, if not the only closest moment that Kreese shares with Johnny that falls back to the theme of father and son. The main indicator of this is the reluctance where Johnny is unsure to put his arm around him or hug him, as this is probably the first time he can remember them being this close. Kreese is also the one to remind him that he needs to live his lessons. If he's teaching the students to go all in, so should he to patch up the relationship with his son. And again, despite Johnny saying it wouldn't happen, it did. When Kreese and Johnny clash over the philosophies, Kreese hints that showing weakness and letting his guard down would leave him vulnerable. Kreese was right in a way, because if Miguel hadn't showed Robbie mercy, he would have avoided being seriously injured. And although him taking Cobra Kai back to prove to Johnny that he wasn't ready to be a sensei yet was sneaky, he tried to do it with good intentions, but the execution in my opinion would have been bad no matter how he went about it. And what seems to be a recurring gag in the series, Kreese has always given Johnny multiple last chances. Going off of season 3 alone, he gave him one at the bar, one at the park, and one before they fight after the Christmas party. In season 4, which in my opinion really changed him into being more Miyagi-like for the first time with Johnny, is when we really see Kreese's softer side with three people, with the first being Johnny. Although it took some convincing, Kreese understands Silver's strategy on focusing solely on the tournament to prepare the students for battle. Though he's trying to prove his loyalty to Kreese, John disapproves of the strategy that Silver is using by beating Lawrence to throw Miguel off balance. There's a look of worry and confusion on his face, either because Terry is going back on his word, this is against the agreement that they made with the dojos, and or he cares about Johnny and doesn't want him getting hurt. It's definitely the last reason when he tells Silver to leave him alone, just like Miyagi told him the same thing when he was choking out Johnny in 1984. Despite his quote in season 2, the other side never fights with any honor, Kreese still has some sense of honor left after all and disapproves of the situation. This is further proven when he attempts to apologize to Johnny about the entire situation. He also expresses that he's always cared about Johnny, despite his actions proving otherwise. It's also after this conversation during Tori's match with Sam that he looks over at Johnny and realizes what he did in the past is what sent him down into a spiral, not his match with Daniel. He therefore changes his actions and leaves the decision up to Tori to fight how she wants, instead of going along with Terry's advice, which was similar to sweeping the leg in 1984. The other two people he has soft spots for are also his students, Robbie and Tori. With Robbie, he sees the same potential he saw in Johnny and is trying to do at the time opposite of what he did with Johnny, making him a champion to beat Miyagi-Do to change the course of history. Kreese also realizes that Robbie's independent and allows him a place to stay as long as he sees fit. Even when not wanting to give Kenny a chance, it is Robbie who he listens to when he tells him that Sean gave him a hard time and to also give him a second tryout. Wanting to avoid a repeat of what happened at the old dojo, he also prevents Silver from attacking Robbie and advises him what to do during overtime. It's clear that Tori reminds him of a younger version of himself. He understands her situation of having a sick mother and having to fend for herself. He also doesn't try to dismiss her claim of being responsible for her actions and try to coax her that it was Sam's fault because he knew what happened at the school. The fact that he goes out of his way to want to financially take care of her problems is more than likely what he also would have done for a younger Johnny if he was in that situation. Kreese even goes as so far to take care of the creepy landlord to back off of Tori and to make a new arrangement regarding her living situation. We see more of this in First Learned Stand. He knows something is wrong when she lashes out at Robbie for catching her off guard. He hears her out and offers his own advice on what she needs to do next. In a way of history repeating itself, he takes Tori's word and confronts Amanda about what happened at the restaurant. In one of the most logical and civil discussions that he's had with someone in the series, Kreese reaches a common ground with Amanda and respects her trying to defend her daughter, as all mothers should. But he also makes it clear that Tori doesn't have a healthy one to defend her, and that Amanda needs to leave her alone if she can't defend herself. It's also realizing that she doesn't need to go down the same spiral Johnny went down is how he breaks the cycle with Tori. By leaving the fight up to her on what she needs to do, she ends up fighting with both mercy and honor against Sam and avoiding fighting dirty to win. This is also so uncharacteristic that Silver notes that Kreese displaying sympathy for someone is a first. Unfortunately, this is his downfall along with bringing back Terry. And now his quote in LOL has a double meaning. You're going to let your guard down and that's going to leave you vulnerable. This is what exactly happens, leading to his downfall and getting arrested. Here are my final thoughts on Kreese and what we could see from him in the future. I will be the first to admit that I never thought we would see a more humane side of Kreese, but I'm glad we have. John, unfortunately, is an example of a tale all too common. Someone realizing that they went too far down the wrong path, but now realize it's too late to turn back because of the lack of time or the damage they have caused. As I mentioned before, perhaps there were some good intentions behind his actions, but they were all terribly executed. It also proves Mr. Miyagi's quote to be true. No such thing as a bad student, only a bad teacher. Kreese followed everything that Captain Turner taught him to a T, and all it did was lead many people down the wrong path. In my opinion, Kreese is what would have happened to Mr. Miyagi if he reacted to his time in the military and the trauma of losing his loved ones with anger instead of sadness. In season 5, I predict Kreese will reflect on his actions and what led to this point, possibly reconciling to an extent with Johnny. I also think that Tori will be a key in helping Kreese, as it's clear she respects him more than Silver, and also knows that Silver paid off the ref. How exactly she will help Kreese is unknown at this point, but I would love to see Kreese get out and fight Silver one-on-one to take control back of the dojo. There are rumors circulating that Martin Cove won't be in Cobra Kai past season 5, so only time will tell what will happen to the King Cobra. Maybe we can see him return to who he was before he was corrupted by Captain Turner. As far as corruption goes, you need to make sure that you're using a VPN to protect your information in the event that Terry Silver takes your dojo away from you. Click on the link in the description to get a NordVPN 2-year plan with a huge discount. Here's why you need to secure yourself a NordVPN. You can use it to unlock Netflix and your favorite entertainment websites that are not available here in the US. You can connect up to 6 devices at the same time with one account. There's no data logging whatsoever, and it works even in China. If you're out and about and using public Wi-Fi networks in places such as coffee shops and airports, NordVPN will protect you with double data encryption for increased anonymity. There is no shame in striking when the time is right, especially if you have to wait in the shadows to do so. NordVPN works with Windows, macOS, Linux, iOS, and Android, has a Chrome extension which is very user-friendly, and unlimited bandwidth. If you're not happy with it for any reason, there's a 30-day money-back guarantee. NordVPN was a 7-time champion in 2021, winning the Business Choice, Reader's Choice, and Best Tech Product of 2021 from PC Mag, Best Android VPN from Android Central, the Best All-Around VPN from Expert Reviews, Best VPN Service from Forbes Advisor, and App Development Team of the Year from App Promotion Summit. It's also the only VPN to get all the green checks on PC Mag. So what are you waiting for? Use the link in the description to get yourself secured with NordVPN. Shout out to NordVPN for giving me the opportunity to be an affiliate. Let me know what you guys think down below. What was your favorite part of Kreese's character arc? If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like, subscribe, share it with your friends, and comment, as these all help my channel grow. If you guys can, be sure to check out and subscribe to my second gaming channel. I'm trying to get this channel partnered as well, and supporting this channel also helps me support my main channel. Shout out to my Twitch subscribers and YouTube members, I appreciate the support. If you'd like to directly support the channel, consider becoming a member and enjoy perks such as behind the scenes updates, access to the VIP Discord, shoutouts and videos, and more. Thanks for watching, stay beautiful, stay awesome, and we'll catch you around next time.